Welcome everyone, this video will show the making of a ring with crushed lapis inlay. I've made some similar rings out of wood, but wanted to try a metal one this time. I'm starting with a round bar, and I'm just using a 6061 aluminum alloy, which actually seems to be great for rings, and a good material to start off with. It's not going to be as scratch resistant as stainless steel or titanium, but it's a lot easier to work with. I'm starting with a piece about 2 inches long and using a lathe to turn the outside down to size. Now I'm drilling a hole for the inside, and will step up the drill bit size until I can switch to a boring bar. It's important to check the measurement often so it doesn't get too big. Once the inside is the right size, I part off the hollowed out section. I was trying to get 2 rings out of this section, but realized it wasn't wide enough. So, I had to cut it down to the right width for 1 ring. Now it's time to cut a channel for the inlay material. I use calipers to mark the channel edges and follow up with a pencil to make it more visible. Next, the tool post is set up to bevel the outside edges. I have to pull the ring off the mandrel and flip it around to get to the other side. Now the ring is taken off the mandrel and placed in the chuck jaws to cut bevels for the inside. This makes the ring more comfortable. Especially once it's sanded down. I'm starting with a fine grit because the cuts in this aluminum were already really clean. Before placing the inlay, I scratch up the channel with 120 grit sandpaper. I start by applying a bit of thick CA glue and then sprinkle on some crushed lapis stone and pack it down, repeating the process all the way around the ring. At the end, I use some thin CA to soak the inlay and make sure all of the stone is secure. Now that the glue is dry, I file the inlay to keep the cutting tool from catching on jagged edges and ripping out stones in the next step. I use a flat support when sanding the outside face of the ring, otherwise the stone and metal might sand down at different rates. I went up to 3000 grit and used water with a fine grit paper. You can start to see it shine with the steel wool. Then I used some polishing compound and it shined some more. A few coats of thin CA make a nice protective coating. I use thicker CA for the last two coats. One last bit of polishing and our ring is finished. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.